are you ready? Yeah. Did you pack your bags?
No.
Did you realize that today is the last day of adventure in the faith forest?
We had so much of fun.
Yeah, why do you have to stop the adventure?
But this is not the end of our adventure.
How?
You want to know how?
Yep.
Because our life is an adventure. And our journey of faith continues until we see Jesus. Isn't that exciting?
Yeah! Not stopping the adventure!
Not at all! Not at all! Our adventure continues! So let us happily sing!
Yeah.
And let us happily enjoy the last day in the faith forest!
Yeah.
We are in the season 5! And we are the Wild Rangers! We are tracing the footprints of faith. That's right, everybody. Let us sing and praise God. Come on.
All around.
That's right, time's up. Come on, everybody, let's open up our Bibles to Matthew 24. Shall we all open our Bibles to Matthew 24 and verse 30? Let us read it together. Ready?
Ready.
Matthew 24:13. But the one who stands firm to the end will be saved. So let's get started. Repeat the words after me. Matthew 24:13.
Matthew 24:13.
Good job. Matthew 24:13.
Matthew 24:13.
But the one.
Who stands firm to the end,
will be saved.
Matthew
24, 13. That's right. Matthew 24:13. I'm sure you got this. Did you get it, Wild Rangers? Don't forget the last roar for today.
Roar.
That's right. So let's say it one last time. Repeat it after me. Matthew 24:13.
Matthew 24:13. Matthew 24:13.
But the one.
But the one.
But the one.
But the one.
Who stands firm.
Who stands firm.
Who stands firm.
Who stands firm.
To the end.
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 Will be saved.
That's the climax, Wild Rangers. We will all be saved when we stand firm to the end. All right, you did a great job.
Thank you.
Wild Rangers. Where were we at yesterday?
Ravens Range.
That's right. Ravens. We were at the Ravens Range. And what did the guide tell us yesterday?
We should hear and do the word of God.
That's right. To obey is to hear and do the word of God. That's right. Hey, the jewel.
Hey, the next jewel.
Jewel.
That's our last jewel for the day.
Mm-hmm. That's right. But you never know what exciting stuff is awaiting us. Yep. Isn't that? Okay, Wild Rangers. So where are we going now?
Let's check the map.
Okay. We were at the hippo hotspot and then the crocodile lake and then the Ravens Range and hey, the scariest part and most thrilling,
the Lion's
Cave! Woohoo! Seth, are you not afraid of lions?
No. Lions?
Because you have never seen one, is it?
Do we have to go to the Lion's Cave?
Don't you want to? It's quite exciting and thrilling.
But will lions bite us?
Nah, they'll eat us.
Oh.
Don't worry, we have the guide with us. Okay guys, so let's go and see what the guide has to say. Are you ready, Wild Rangers?
Yes!
Nah. That's better. Come on, let's go. Hello children, good morning. How are you? Children, let me ask you something. Who is called the king of the jungle? Wow, you must be thinking, that's such a silly question. Who doesn't know it? I know you all are very smart. Yes, the lion is called the king of the jungle. But you know something, children? The most funniest part is that lions usually don't live in jungles. Most of the lions live in open grasslands, which are called as savannas, or you know, some open grasslands. But most of the lions don't live in the jungles, except for the lions who are in India. Yes, they live in those forests. Whatever it is, we all know that lions are so ferocious, they are so strong, they are so brave. All the guys and girls, if we ask them, which animal do you want to be? You know, maybe you all would say, roar, I want to be like a lion, isn't it? Yes, we all like that huge and ferocious and bold and strong lion. You know, just when we look at the lion, it feels so huge and so big and so nice, isn't it? With all the mane around, and then when it walks, looks like the king, and then wow, it looks so nice. I know, that is God's creation. You see, children, these lions, they are very famous for their roar, right? Yes, when they roar so loud, it can be heard up to 8 kilometers. Whoa, that's too far and that's too loud, right? Yes, a lion's roar is really powerful, isn't it? And lions don't live alone. They usually live like, you know, 10 to 15 lions or 20 to 30 lions. They live in groups. And that's a group of lions are called as a pride. They are called as pride. And usually, it's the female lion who does all the hunting and the male lions, they protect their territory and they'll be like, hey, nobody has to enter into this and this is our home, this is our place and things like that. And you know something, children? A male lion eats up to 7 cages of meat at one go and a female lion can eat up to 5 cages of meat in one go. And they digest the food so easily and so fast that they feel hungry again, very fast. And that is why we see these lions hunting down huge animals, right? Like zebras and deers and wild bees and things like that. And these lions run at a speed of 81 kilometers per hour. Whoa, they run really fast. They are very good athletes, isn't it? You know, children, they can go without drinking water for up to 4 to 5 days. Wow, that's a really superpower. Can we live without drinking water for one day? No, we cannot. What will happen if we don't drink lots of water? I know. Mommy always says, right? Drink water, drink water, drink water. And even in our schools, our teachers and everybody are like, drink water, please drink water, please drink water, right? Because water is very good for us. But you know something? These lions have a superpower. They can go without drinking water for almost 4 to 5 days. They can just use up the moisture which is in their stomach and they can stay without drinking water. Isn't our God's creation so amazing, children? Yes, it is. So there were few lions who were not in the jungle, who were not in the forest, but they were in a place called Babylon. And these lions, you know, they were just staying there, and they were a group of lions who were there. They were getting their meat every day, they were getting their food every day, and they used to take these lions to do shows like the gladiator shows, or like, you know, just to make them walk around and know that, oh wow, look at this kingdom. This kingdom of Babylon, they have lions with them and things like that. So they used to keep these lions in this place where they used to keep them caged or captive, or, you know, in that special den which they were there. In those days, the people who were in Babylon, or the government who was there, it was a method of punishment to, you know, punish people who were not obeying or who disobeyed the law, or, you know, who were being bad or who did not listen to the king's orders. They used to put those people into these lions' den and the lions would eat them. So one day these lions were just sitting, and then they were talking and playing, and they were doing something, and, you know, they were busy in their own world. But suddenly, when all of them were just sitting peacefully and just thinking, you know, oh, we are feeling so hungry, what do we do now? It's been a while that we've eaten food, and I told you, right, they are very good at digesting their food. So the food is already digested, so what do we do now? Oh, we are feeling so hungry, stomach is all gurgly and grrr, and, you know, different kinds of sounds in the stomach. When the lions were just sitting and thinking, what do we eat, how do we, you know, get rid of this hunger, suddenly they saw somebody appear in white clothes. And who was it? Oh, he was the angel of the Lord. And, you know, these lions were like, what is the angel of the Lord doing here? And they were looking at each other, and they're like, what happened? You know, the angel of the Lord said, hey, listen, lions, there is a command from the Almighty God, and he commanded you to just shut your mouths and not, you know, open your mouths. Then the lion said, why? What is going to happen? Is there somebody who's going to come inside? Can we eat him? Then the angel of the Lord said, yes, that is what I'm trying to tell you. There is a servant of God who's going to come inside this den now, and you guys are not going to open your mouth and eat him. Mind it, this is a command from the Almighty God. Then these lions were like, wow, is that true? Did God send an angel to tell us that we are not supposed to eat a man? Who is this man? What is so special about this man? What is it? Then the angel of the Lord said, yes, this servant of the Almighty God is really, really special. You know something, lions? Because he stood for his faith, and God wants to protect him. That is why he sent me to command you not to open your mouths and hurt his servant. And these lions were like, wow, really? Angel of the Lord, we really do not understand what you are telling about. We really want to hear more about this man. Who is the special servant of God? Who's going to come and then we are not going to touch him? What did he do? How did he stand for his faith? Then the angel of the Lord said, you see, lions, this man, his name is called Daniel. And, you know, he is not from this place. You guys are here in Babylon, right? But this man is not from Babylon. Instead, he's an Israelite. He's a Jew, and he is from a place called Jerusalem. But you know something, lions? When this boy, Daniel, was still a little teenager, the Babylonian king went into their country, they destroyed their country, and the king brought Daniel and his friends and, you know, everybody who were with him to this country, which is called Babylon. So, you know something, lions? This boy, Daniel, he was so strong and so faithful to obey to the voice of the living God that he did not do anything to displease God in any way. Then all the lions were listening to what the angel of the Lord was telling them. They were like, wow. So one of the lions who was so curious said, okay, so can you give us an example? Like, how did he stand?
Then the angel of the Lord said, you know, when these people, these young teenagers, these boys came to Babylon, you know, the king, he offered them different kinds of meat and food and different kinds of food and things like that. And he said, everybody has to eat this and everybody has to drink this wonderful, you know, juice and everything which is available all over the place. And you have to become really, really strong and you have to become really, really wise. And then you can be ministers and helpers to the king. But then this boy, Daniel, he knew that this meat or this wine or this drink or whatever the food that is being offered to them has already been offered to the idols or the gods of Babylon. That is why, because he is a child of God, he is not going to touch that food. See, dear lions, even though this boy was so young, he was just a teenager, yet he knew that he had to stand for the living God. And you know something? This boy went and told the person who was in charge of them. He said, you see, we are not going to eat whatever the king is offering to us, whatever the meat and all these things, but we are going to eat fruits and vegetables or something which is very simple. You test us and see if we will really be stronger than all the other boys who are there. Then we can continue eating whatever we want to eat, right? So the angel of the Lord said, you see, lions, Daniel determined in his heart that he will not sin against the Almighty God by eating this food which was being offered to the gods of Babylon. Instead, he chose to eat something else like fruits and vegetables. And then, because of his faith, because of what he believed, God honored him. And he and his friends were able to find favor in the sight of the person who was in charge and also in the sight of the king. And so these lions were so excited and they were like, wow, really, angel of the Lord? Did he really stand? Did he really determine himself? Did he really not eat what the people were offering? Instead, he chose to please God. Wow, he is really brave. He is really bold. Just like us, we lions are also so bold and brave, right? Oh, so it means Daniel is also like us. He's so bold and so brave, thought the lions. And then the angel of the Lord said, yes, you're right. Daniel is very brave. He's very bold. And you know something? God has helped Daniel to be so wise and, you know, to be so smart and so intelligent than all the other people who are in this place called the Babylon. And then God blessed him and he was able to find favor in the eyes of the king and all the other people. The angel of the Lord told the lions, you see, guys, you've just come here, but you know something? Daniel, the servant of the Almighty God, he is there here since the reign of King Nebuchadnezzar. He was a helper, he was a minister and advisor to King Nebuchadnezzar, and then he was there when King Belshazzar was the king, and now it is King Darius, and Daniel is still here. Then all the lions were like, wow, so Daniel is really old now, isn't he? Then the angel of the Lord said, yes, but you know something, lions? Though Daniel is old and though Daniel has spent so many years in Babylon, yet he did not forget that he belonged to the living God and that he chose to follow God no matter what. All through these years, though he was not in his land, still he chose to follow the living God. And that is why God sent me to tell you not to harm the servant of the living God who is going to come inside now. Then one of the lions said, okay, angel of the Lord, all this is really nice, but I have a question. Then he said, what? You see, all this is very good, but now why is he coming inside? You did not tell us why he's coming now. Then the angel of the Lord said, yes, yes, that's a very good question. Let me answer you. You know something? Because Daniel is so wise, and you know, because all the kings like him, and because all the people like him, there are some jealous people, there are some wicked people, there are some people who don't like Daniel, and they are so jealous about him that the king likes him so much. You know, these jealous people, they forced the king and they made a rule saying that nobody should worship or bow down or pray to any other god except the king. And the angel of the Lord said, you know something, lions? Daniel is a faithful servant of God because he prays every day. Every day he kneels down and he prays and he speaks to God. Then all the lions were like listening to him in like, you know, surprise. And then they were like, so what happened next? Then the angel of the Lord said, you know, the rule read that anybody who does not follow this rule, who will kneel down and pray or will worship or, you know, who will pray to any other god other than the king, they are going to be thrown into the lion's den. Then the lions are like, oh, so this is where we come in. Oh, ho. Then the angel of the Lord said, you see, lions, because Daniel is such a faithful servant of God and because he always stands for his faith all through these years, though he is in Babylon, he did not forget that he belongs to the living God and he did not start mixing himself up with these Babylons or, you know, worshipping their idols, praying to their gods or, you know, eating the food which is offered to the idols or, you know, enjoying with all the other things which are in Babylon. But he always remembers that he is a child of God and he has to stay pure and holy because he is a child of a living God. Then all the lions were like, wow, Daniel is so bold, he's so brave, he's so strong. Then the angel of the Lord said, yes, lions, you know something? Though the order was passed that anybody who prays to any other god other than the king is going to be thrown into the lion's den, yet Daniel knelt down and prayed. And these jealous people who are waiting to put him and kill him and do something because he has favor with the king, oh, they are so happy now. They went, they grabbed Daniel, they chained him, and they are bringing him now. That is why God sent me to you, so that you will not open your mouths, hurt him or do anything to him. Then all the lions were like so surprised and so shocked and they were eager to see Daniel. Who is this man that God sent the angel of the Lord to protect him and shut our mouths? And they all were waiting eagerly. And even before the lions could realize, they saw the opening of the den and then they saw that a man was being thrown into the lion's den. And all the lions were like, whoa, so this is the man you're talking about. And the angel of the Lord was like, yes, he is Daniel, the servant of the Most High, the servant of the Almighty God. And all the lions were like, angel of the Lord, you don't have to worry about us. We will not open our mouths. We will not hurt Daniel. Though we are feeling so hungry, yet we will not hurt him because the Almighty God has commanded us. And then we know now that Daniel has obeyed and stood for his faith alone. Even though he was all alone, he stood for his faith, and that is why he's been thrown into the lion's den. Why are we going to hurt him? No, he is as bold as us and we are as bold as him. Daniel obeyed the voice of the Lord and we will also obey the voice of the Lord. And we are not going to hurt Daniel, said the lions. Wow! And the angel of the Lord was so happy and all the lions were so happy. And all through the night, they spent time with Daniel. And early in the morning, even before the sun came up, they saw that the den was being opened and they were like, oh, who is this who came early in the morning? And they heard the voice of the king and he was like, Daniel, Daniel, are you there? Then Daniel replied from inside. He said, yes, my dear king, my God has sent his angel and he shut the mouth of these lions and then I am alive, I am safe. And all these lions were like, wow, really? The king likes this man so much. That's so wonderful. That's so amazing. That's really nice, thought the lions. And then the king commanded his soldiers to bring Daniel out of the lion. And Daniel went out of the lion. But these lions really never forgot who Daniel was and who was that man who stood for his faith. So children, what can we learn today? You see what the angel of the Lord was telling the lions? That Daniel, though he was a young boy, he determined in his heart that he will not sin against God. What does that mean? That he will not listen to whatever people are telling all around him, because all the other young boys were eating what the king was offering, were eating what the Babylonians were offering, were drinking what the Babylonians were offering and wearing all those things and putting on all those things and things like that. But then, though people around him were doing what they were doing, Daniel determined in his heart, he made it up in his mind that even though nobody is standing with me, I will stand alone, but I determine to please my God. You see children, our friends might be wasting time on different kinds of social media and different kinds of networking. Our friends might be wasting time on different kinds of, you know, chats and things like that. Our friends might be wasting time on different kinds of groups, or, you know, talking about sports, or, you know, something that is not really useful for our education or for our spiritual life. But just wasting time just like that on different kinds of unnecessary things. If we determine in our hearts to step back and stand out from it, people are going to laugh at us. People are going to make fun of us. People are going to say that, oh, she's so crazy, he's so crazy, they don't have a life, or things like that. But then children, if we determine in our hearts, like Daniel, to stand strong and be bold and brave, God will honor us just like how he honored Daniel. And God will be there with us. And the second thing, children, Daniel did not go and protest in front of the king because he has favor of the king, right? Think about it, children. The king loves Daniel so much. Yet Daniel did not go and tell the king saying that, hey king, what did you do? Why did you pass that rule? Don't you know that I pray every day? Oh, even if this is happening, how unfair is this? Oh, those people are so jealous. Those people are so bad. They made you do all this. Doesn't Daniel know that those people have wantedly done it? But did Daniel voice out? No, he did not. See children, we are not made to protest or do something, or, you know, go out and be so loud and speak out for our rights or things like that. No, we don't have to do all those things, children. Just like how Daniel was doing, keep doing what you are doing. Regardless of what the obstacles around us, if we keep doing what we are doing and stick to the faith and the salvation and the gift that God has given to us, he will help us. He will take care of us. We don't have to go out and protest or do anything, or, you know, stand up and argue with our friends about something, what they don't believe, what we believe, or what they are doing is wrong, or what we are doing is wrong, and things like that. We can learn to continue to do what we are doing faithfully all through our lives, like Daniel. When we do that, God is going to help us. And God is going to bring us into the notice of people, just like how King Darius was able to recognize that the God whom Daniel is serving is a living God. God will bring such moments in our lives. And children, Daniel, though he was living in a foreign country, that home was not his home actually. He belonged to Jerusalem, right? But though he was living in Babylon, yet he stood for his faith. When they put him into the lion's den, was he a young man? No, like we see in the pictures, actually that is not true. Daniel was put into the lion's den when King Darius was there. That means he was almost about 75 to 80 years old. He was an old man. Yet, all through these years, right from his teenage years, where he started his relationship with Nebuchadnezzar to King Belshazzar and to King Darius, he was being faithful in serving the Almighty God, though he was in a foreign land with foreign people who were worshipping foreign gods. We are also living in such times, aren't we? How are we standing? How is our faith testifying about whom we serve to our friends and people around us? How are we able to testify our faith to our friends and our family members. Let us be like Daniel children. There are going to be times when things are going to get more and more difficult for us in future, because Jesus told in the Bible that people are going to hate you because you follow me. People are going to insult you because you follow me. People are going to count you as fools, like I already told you, because you follow me. But then you have to stand, you have to move forward and dare to be different, stand for the truth, even if you are standing alone, even if you are the only believer in your class. Stand for the truth and stand up for what you believe, so that people will see the love of Jesus and people will see that you serve a living God and that I serve a living God. Shall we be like Daniel children? Yes, we will. And for us to be like Daniel, we need a Bible, a quiet time, time of prayer like Daniel, and our fellowship and relationship with God and our fellowship with our fellow believers. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for giving us this opportunity. Please help us to live like Daniel and help us to find favor with you and help us to be called your servants, so that we will live for our faith and stand for the truth no matter what. Please give us the strength. Be with us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us dare to be different children and let us stand up for the truth. Even if we are the only ones, even if we are all alone, let us stand up for the truth, just like Daniel did. God bless you. Since we will be starting our school soon and we all need time to prepare and brush our subjects, we will not be meeting every day from next week, but we will surely be meeting every Friday and Saturday at 6 o'clock in the evening from the coming week. Stay tuned and stay blessed. I'm sure you had a wonderful time with us in learnings in lockdown. We sure did have fun and we are so encouraged and happy by your participation. Our friendship will continue as we continue these episodes further into the next weeks. We will see you on Friday again. Until then, stay safe, stay home, and be blessed. And don't forget, Wild Rangers, Jesus loves you. And we all love you. And this is from Learnings in Lockdown team. See you soon. Bye, everybody. Take care.